Welcome here. This is a new YouTube video by the Ceuster Academy. When you're here for the first time, please subscribe and click on the bell button so that whenever we upload a new video, YouTube will in fact inform you about it. In this presentation, I'm going to look again at the alternative method of identifying the critical path and calculating the float or the slack. But now we have something a little bit tricky in here. It's a little bit more advanced than the previous video. Now let's start. We have again the precedence diagram, but you will notice there are some differences there. So we have again A and B, A with a duration of 5, B with a duration of 2. We have the start here. Then we have C where we have then D, which are behind A, C with a duration of 4. We have D also with a duration of 3. We have E, but now E is also a predecessor, as A as a predecessor. So we have E with 4, and the graph is a little bit more complex, a little bit more arrows. F, we have C and D. F, C, and D with a duration of 6. And G also has D and E as predecessors. So our schedule is a little bit more complex. We have a few arrows, a few precedences, more than in the previous diagram. But basically, the principle stays the same. Now, what are the diagrams? What are the paths through the network? We have ACF, which has a duration of 5 plus 4 plus 6 is 15. ADF, which is 5 plus 3 plus 6 is 11 plus 3 is 14. Now we have ADG. DG. We have 5 plus 3 plus 2 is 10. Then we have AEG. 5 plus 4 is 9 plus 2 is 11. And then we have BEG, which is 2 plus 4 plus 2 is 8. You see that we have now more paths through the network. And the first thing to do is the critical path. The critical path is the path which is the longest. So ACF is in fact the CP. Now A, C, and F are in fact on the critical path, so their slack is basically zero. They don't have any flexibility. When we talk about slack, we talk about flexibility. We cannot move A, C, or F without changing the duration of the project. So we have A and F, A and A here. These are, in fact, the activities with slack zero. Now let's look at B, activity B. For B, we have B is on the path BEG with a duration of 8. And we have to compare this with the critical path. Now B and E, we can look at them at the same time. B and E are on the path with the 8, and we compare it with the 15. So the slack of B and E is 7. Now we have to be careful here because G is on two paths. So we have G on this path. Sorry, it's on three paths. Now for G, we have to look at the path ADG, which has a duration of 10. AEG, which has a duration of 11, and BEG, which has a duration of 8. So when I compare each of those with the critical path, I see that here G would have 15 minus 10, a slack of 5. Here I would have a slack of 4, and here I would take a slack of 7. Now, which one is the right one? Well, we have to take the longest part, because the longest part is compared with the critical part, which is the absolute longest part. So we have to take the longest part on which I have G, subtract that value from the critical part, and find the slack. So in this case, the slack of G is 4. So what did we find? We find B and E with the slack of 5. In another color, blue, we find G with the slack of 4. And I still have D. Here's E. D again is on two parts. So when we have D, D is on the part ADG, ADG and ADF. And on ADG, we have 10, ADF, we have 14. So basically we take 14 and we see that D has a slack equal to 1. So now we have all of them. I don't have any other colors left, so I will do this. Slack of 1. So basically, when we have activities which are not on the critical path, but are on different paths, we have to find the longest path on which that activity is, and then compare it with the critical path. Just to remind you that when we do this method, it's very important to follow this rule. If you have multiple paths on which an activity is occurring, then you may have a problem when you just select one of them. Basically, you always have to take the longest path and then compare it with the rest. Let's have a look if our reasoning corresponds with the calculation, the classical calculations. We will do the calculation now the classical way, so we do the forward pass and the backward pass. So we start with 1. And I must say that I made an error here for E, because E is on two paths. E is on A, E, G, and B, E, G. So when we take B, E, G, we have 8. When we have A, E, G, we have 11. So basically E has a slack of 15 minus 11. Is 4. So basically I made some error there, but I found it was working on the board. It's not always the same like working on the table. So this is the basic thing that we can say here, that we found the same results. I corrected my error. I'm not perfect. I'm sure nobody is. Everybody makes an error from time to time, but it's better not to make it on an exam. Anyway, you've seen how this works. So this is only for B and not for E. So slack of B is 7, slack of E is 4. I hope you like this. This was a more complex exercise. We have more paths on which an activity is placed. So we always have to take the longest part to compare it with the critical part. So these are some elements to consider. It's an easier way to look at it, but in some cases, it may also have its own complications. You may easily make a mistake, but when you're concentrated, I'm sure it will not happen. This was a little bit more complicated exercise compared to the previous video. Here we had those activities that appeared on more than one path. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed it, that you learned it, that you understand the method, also its simplicity, but also the small complexities that can be here. This was it for this video. If you're here for the first time, do not forget to subscribe to our channel and click on the bell button so every time we upload a video, YouTube will inform you. Thank you very much and see you soon. Bye-bye.